Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and this week I'm going to restore a feature that Todoist recently took away. Well, not really restore it, but I'm going to show you a way of being able to recreate the feature using filters. What feature am I talking about? I'm talking about the ability to be able to go into a parent project, click on that, and see all the sub-projects nicely organized in your view window, which if you go and test it, you'll find no longer happens. So what can you do about it? Well, you can actually use filters to recreate that, and that is what I'm going to show you how to do this week. Now, I don't know if Todoist are going to bring this feature back. I don't know if this was a mistake. I have no idea, but it has gone, and a lot of people have found it a little bit disruptive, and they want it to come back because they were using it for their workflows. So that's what I'm going to show you this week. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you would like to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me now take you into my Todoist and show you how to restore the missing feature. Okay, I'm sure that many of you have probably discovered this feature change or this feature removal that Todoist has recently introduced. In the past, when you actually hit a parent, and I've got a parent task here, and I've got three sub-projects underneath. In the past, when you actually hit the parent folder, you would actually get these subfolders all nicely shown below. As you can see right now, that feature has disappeared. Now, I don't know if Todoist are planning on bringing this back. Maybe they will, so maybe this video is going to be completely out of date in the next few weeks. But there is something that you can do to work around this if this feature was something that was vital to your workflow. And the way to do that is to use filters. So let's just go down to my filters here. This is one that I actually created earlier. And what you can see is I have essentially recreated the same feature, but this time I'm using filters. Now, essentially what you're doing is you've got your daily routines here, I've got my weekly routines here, and I've got my monthly routines here. Now, when I think about this, what I'm realizing is that probably the reason Todoist has moved it is simply because of now that we have sections within a project and they're trying to encourage you to use sections. Maybe that's the reason, that's just my guess. So what you can do is to set this up, all you need to do is click on the three ellipses right here and edit the filter or create a new filter. And what you'll see is I've actually created this by using the three projects. Now, to show a project individually, you need to use the double hashtag. So I've got double hashtag daily, double hashtag weekly, double hashtag monthly, and they are separated by a comma. That's how you actually get it this way. So this is how you would separate the actual sub projects. Now, for those of you who don't want to separate the sub projects, you can actually do it this slightly different way. So let's go back in and edit the filter. And instead of using a comma, you use, and I have no idea what this is called, the vertical line. That's what I'm going to call it anyway. I know I'm probably wrong, and I'm sure in the comments below you will correct me and tell me what this symbol is. When I do that, if I save that, what you'll see now is this is now showing them all as one complete list. Maybe that's what you want to do. I don't know, but if that's what you want to do, that's what you can do. So to change this back, because I don't really want to do it that way, I like to see them separated. I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to do comma after daily. I'm going to put a comma after weekly and then hit save, and now it separates them out. And the next step you can do, particularly with projects that you are going into on a regular basis, of course, the next thing you can do is you can pin this to favorite. So if I tap that, now I have it in my favorites right up here, so I can click on that at any time. So I can go to upcoming, and there we go, upcoming is coming up here. I can hit my routines and it's going to show me the different sections. So you can play around with this and you can get a little bit creative, and you can actually start adding it back the feature, although as I say, it's not exactly the way you may want it. But you know, sometimes we have to compromise, sometimes we have to modify things just to get it so that it fits the way we want it to fit. And so for those of you who really want this feature back, and if it takes a while for Todoist to do it, even if they don't ever bring it back, this is one way that you can bring it back for yourself and just use the filters. So just to remind you there, when we go back into the filter here, I'm going to go down to my routines here. I'm going to hit on the three dots. I'm going to add the ellipses, and there you go. That's what you need. You need the hashtag daily, comma, hashtag weekly, comma, hashtag monthly. And it needs to be written obviously exactly as you have it as the sub project. So there you go. Hopefully that helps you. If you've really missing this feature, this is one way of bringing it back. As I say, it's not an elegant way, but I have no idea whether Todoist is going to bring this feature back or not. Maybe they will, maybe they won't, but it doesn't matter because there is a workaround and you can get it so it's set like this. So there you go. Hopefully that's given you a little bit of an update, how to use your filters in a creative way. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.